Hi guys, I'm Srishti and I'll be covering finance current affairs. So today we'll be talking about the reasons and impact of lowering interest rates. So as we all know that this is a hot topic. So we'll start with this. So the question is, countries are reducing the interest rates in the era of triple lows. What are the measures countries are restoring to revive the growth? Choose from the options given below. So there are four options given below, and out of these four options the codes are given from which you have to find the answer. So the first is, quantitative easing is adopted by countries to solve the problem of economic slowdown. Second is, lowering interest rates will have dual effect on inflation and growth. Third is, international cooperation between the countries is helping to solve the problem of T-lows. T-lows is the triple lows. And fourth is, countries are considering external borrowings to increase the private investment demand. So, before answering the question, let us understand the concept of reasons and the impacts of lower interest rates by developed and developing economies. So as we all know that there are two types of monetary policies. First is conventional policy and another is unconventional policy. So the conventional policy is wherein central banks like RBI implement their monetary policy through interest rates, which is the traditional measure. So powerful monetary policy is the weapon for short-term interest rates. Example is when RBI reduces its repo rate and the commercial banks also reduces their lending rate. So the overall interest rates goes down, and as a general decrease in interest rates, loans increases. The demand for loans increases and thus the economic activity and growth enhances. So we know that there is conventional policy, and the RBI or the central bank basically implement this through the interest rates. And the repo rate, the term which we have used here, so in brief, the repo rate means the a rate at which RBI lends money to the commercial banks. Now, the another type of unconventional policy here is that unconventional policy is that when central banks look beyond their traditional instrument of policy of the interest rate. So monetary policy takes an unconventional character. So the question here arises is that why not central banks could pursue the conventional policies? So I'll be giving the answer in a few minutes. Firstly, let us understand that what is happening here. So in the conventional policy, by lowering the interest rates, it is a part of conventional measure. So the central bank reduces the interest rates through the repo rates, as we have already discussed here. Then in the unconventional way, the question which I mentioned here is that why not the conventional policy for too long? So the answer is that in periods of economic crisis, they become limited in their usefulness. So if the central bank keeps on decreasing the interest rates, the usefulness decreases and the nominal interest rates cannot be made so low that those banks risk default, and people are also not incentivized, no longer to incentivized to invest. So if the interest rates becomes too low, the banks may risk default and people are also not incentivized to invest. So using conventional monetary policy for too long is not a solution. So a government has to switch to the unconventional policy, and in the unconventional policy, quantitative easing is there. So it is a part of unconventional monetary policy, and it is a strategy that a central bank uses to increase the domestic money supply. So how does this happen? It happens by asset purchases. Now what asset purchases is? So these assets are equally matched by corresponding money flow into the country. So we know that when central bank purchases the assets, it increases its asset, and at the same time when it pays to buy the asset, the money supply also increases. So, by purchasing the asset and by paying for the asset, money supply in the economy goes up. So, government purchases assets to increase money supply and to address the risk of prolonged low inflation rate. So, we'll discuss it in a while that why prolonged low inflation rate and money supply are related to each other. So, the net effect of using the asset purchases is that interest rate in the economy goes down along with the increase in money supply, because as money supply increases, the interest rates, the net effect is that the interest rates in the economy will go down. So the main focus of the government is to bring the interest rates down. So globally the interest rates have been reduced and the countries are planning to cut the interest rates. Now we'll understand that why countries are lowering the interest rates. What is the purpose behind it? So we know the first reason is the fighting against the trade war. So we know that trade wars are persisting in the global economy between China, between US, and US has also reduced its subsidy to India, to China. So there are trade tensions here. So amid all the trade tensions, countries at this time wants to focus on their domestic demand rather than the inter-country demand. So they want to lower the interest rates. Next thing is consumption crisis. Now in sectors like realty, builders are in such a situation that whether to complete the project or not, as there is no buyer. So there is a problem of consumption crisis here. And as a result, reduced interest rates will help to boost the demand in such sectors. So what is the mechanism behind this? We know that as interest rates get lower, it will entice the people to take the loan. So the demand for loanable funds will increase. And as we know that these funds will then be used to invest in productive assets like real estate, like machinery, so thereby increasing the growth in the economy. Now the question arises is that by reducing the interest rates, the demand for loanable funds increases, because when interest rates are lower, the borrowing cost for taking the loan decreases and people find it beneficial to take up the loans. Now the next reason is inflation is below target level. So this is an opportunity for the central banks to reduce the interest rates and bring the inflation up to a decent level. And as the inflation is below the target level, it won't harm the economy if the inflation rate rises also. So because we know that interest rate and inflation are inversely related to each other. So we'll discuss it in the another section. Now we have era of triple lows. So we know that what is the era of triple lows? Problem of T lows means that low inflation rate, low interest rates and low growth. So to come out of the vicious circle, government are using the interest rates. So by lowering the interest rates, it is expecting to boost the growth, as we have already discussed that by reducing the interest rate, the borrowing cost goes down, which increases the demand for loanable funds, and hence it enhances the growth and economic activity. And also when there will be growth, the money will be in circulation in the economy. So as money supply increases, it will bring in the inflation. So by reducing the interest rates, the inflation has gone up with a certain logic that as interest rates are lowered, borrowing cost is also low, which increases the loan. And by increasing the loans, it would get invested in productive assets and hence the growth will increase. So this problem has to be solved by the lowering the interest rates. Then as money supply will increase, there will be inflation. So the problem of inflation will also be solved by lowering the interest rates. But we know that amid the global trade tensions and global scenario, this is not happening. Even though the governments are targeting the interest rates, they are cutting the interest rates down, then also there is no growth or inflation rising up. Now we'll discuss about that what are the effects of lowering the interest rates. So there is no money for investment only, as we know that there is a shortage of money. There is no money supply as such. There is no demand for money. So therefore, to boost the investment and growth, below flowchart is prepared to make you understand the effects of lowering interest rates. So we'll understand this, that as countries lower the interest rates, the borrowing cost goes down, because at that interest rate, for example, the interest rate earlier was 10%, and a person who takes up the loan has to pay 10 rupees as interest on the 100 rupees taken as loan. But now, when the interest rates have gone down, supposedly say 5%, so now on taking the loan for 100 rupees, only 5 rupees has to be paid as interest, and this incentivizes the investors, this incentivizes the company to take up the loans. So borrowing cost goes down. This will increase in the funds demanded. So more and more people will take up the loans, and therefore the amount of loans or the demand for loanable funds will go up. Money will certainly flow in the economy, and money will increase, and then people will invest, thereby boosting the growth and enhancing the economic activity. So this is the flowchart, and this is the reason why the countries are lowering their interest rates. What is the effect of cutting the interest rates further down? Now, the next section that we have to discuss here is measures other than the interest rate cut. So what if the governments don't want to cut the interest rates to such a low level? So one method we have discussed earlier, that is of asset purchases. So ECB, it is considering the asset purchase program. So that was a part of unconventional monetary policy, as we have discussed. Now, what are the other measures other than the interest rate cut or the asset purchases? So the countries are now engaging in the external borrowings. So firstly, we'll discuss overseas sovereign bond. So it is considered as a good decision. Now, what is a sovereign bond? Sovereign bond is basically a bond issued by a national government, generally with a promise to pay periodic interest payments. Like a company issues bonds to finance its expansion, likewise a country issues bond, and that bond is known as a sovereign bond, for bringing in money from abroad for the domestic growth and to finance its expansion domestically. Now, this was the motive behind sovereign bond issue. Now, we know that India is planning for sovereign bond issue to raise the money from outside so that it does not crowd out the private investment demand, because there is already a money crunch in the economy. No one is willing to invest. So that is why there are two types of demand, as we know, public demand or the government investment demand and the private investment demand. So government is taking the help of external borrowings so that the private investment demand does not crowds out. Now also, it is in the news that Indian government considering to take concessional loans from lenders such as World Bank, ADB, European Investment Bank for the green energy. To boost up its green energy sector, Indian government is taking concessional loans from these lenders. So again, it is a type of external borrowings which India is relying upon for its government investment demand. Now, as we know, we have been discussing it for a while, that interest rates cut have been done by many countries and everyone is reducing their interest rates. So what is the drawback or what is the disadvantage of such a move? Now we'll discuss it here, that what is not good here. So we know that a company does not have money to invest. So therefore, the share market, we know that share market is also going down. So this is the reason, because no one have money to invest. So share market is not performing well. So as a result, return on pension funds is also going down. So I'll explain it why. So we know that there are two types of pension funds. First is defined contribution pension fund and the other is defined benefit pension fund. So in the defined contribution fund, it is mostly used by everyone. No one uses defined benefit plan now. Almost everyone is taking up defined contribution pension fund. So DC is where the amount depends upon the amount you contribute and the performance and the fund and investment performance. So the amount that you have contributed, so your employer will invest it somewhere. So they, based on the investment performance and based on the amount you contribute, the amount for DC is calculated. Whereas in defined benefit plan, a specific promised value is given to you after a certain period of time. So mostly defined contribution plans are used, and as we know that pension funds are generally safe funds and they generally try to invest in safe securities like government securities, investment grade bond or blue chip stocks. So blue chip stocks are basically the stocks of the high rated companies. So they generally invest in these type of safe securities. So when the market is going down, these securities, the returns on these securities will also go down, and therefore the return on the pension funds will go down. So if pension funds can't make the targeted return, then more and more money will be invested in the private equity funds or the venture capital, which are risky. So we have discussed this, that the effect of flows to zero rates have on the social security system and on the pension funds, and we have discussed it, that how the money will get diverted from the safe stocks, safe investment, to the risky private equity funds and the venture capital. Now the next topic that we are going to discuss is countries following the Fed rate cuts. So some of the countries like ECB, India, China, Turkey and Australia are following the Fed rate cuts. So here in Tell Me More section, I like to discuss with you that what negative interest rates are and what is the impact of it. So some countries have also negative interest rates, for example Germany. So from minus 0.04% to minus 0.06%, the interest rates have fallen. What does it mean? So it basically means that instead receiving the money on the deposits, depositors must pay regularly to keep their money with the banks. So when you go to a bank, you deposit your funds and you get the interest rates from there. But in banks in Germany, when you go to the bank to keep funds as deposits in the banks, you have to pay the interest to them to keep your money safe. So it have the dual concept, dual principle here, firstly on the banks and other on the depositors. Negative interest rates are there to lend money more freely, whereas from the depositors' point of view, individuals may lend, spend money rather than pay a fee to keep it safe with the banks. So let us read it, that it means banks, central banks, private banks will charge negative interest rate. Instead of receiving money on deposits, depositors must pay regularly to keep their money with the banks. So what is the purpose behind this? To incentivize the banks to lend money more freely and businesses and individuals to invest, lend and spend money rather than pay a fee to keep it safe. So as I have discussed it with you, that it has a dual concept. So coming back to the question, countries are reducing the interest rates in the era of triple lows. So as we have discussed that what triple lows is, so basically what are the measures countries are resorting to revive the growth. So discussing it point wise, quantitative easing is adopted by the countries to solve the problem of economic slowdown. So yes, many central banks like ECBs have resorted to quantitative easing by asset purchase, as we have discussed. And how does it help in reviving the growth? Then second point is, so this point is correct. Then second point is lowering interest rates will have dual effect on inflation and growth. So we have discussed it, and this is also correct, that by lowering the interest rates, the idea is to increase the inflation to a decent level and also to boost up the growth. The third point is international cooperation between the countries is helping to solve the problem of T-lows. So as we know that there are trade tensions, as I have mentioned here, that there are trade tensions. So there is no international cooperation right now because there are trade tensions, and everyone is not considered about the inter-country demand, but they are considered about their domestic demand. So this is not one of the reasons, this is not the measure which the countries are resorting to. They are not taking each other's help, they are not resorting to the international cooperation mechanism. Then we have fourth point, that countries are considering the external borrowings to increase the private investment demand. So we have discussed it, and this is right, that they are resorting to external borrowings like sovereign bonds, or they are taking the concessional loans also from various lenders like World Bank, ADB. So the options which are correct are 1, 2 and 4. So the correct answer here is option number D. So do subscribe to our channel for more regular updates, and thank you.